Beautiful people, good morning. Welcome to my channel. Yeah, this is your girl Tina Parks Flawless. If you have not subscribed to my channel, I don't know what you're waiting for. Please just go and hit the subscribe button and you're free to go. Thank you so much for doing that. Yeah, welcome. This is your one and only Tina Parks Flawless. Yeah. We're going to continue with our topic on how you can care for your children, how you take care of your children, especially now that they are on holidays. Yeah, how can we care for our children? Mothers, please teach your children how to love. Your children should know how to love. And that is why we have so many broken homes, so many marriages are hitting the rock. Because either the man or the woman did not come out from a loving environment. They didn't grow up, you know, in love. They didn't grow up, you know, seeing love, know what love means. That is why you see so many homes broken. That is why you see so many marriages hitting the rock. Because of lack of love. So why not start now to teach your children how to love? Your children should know how to love one another. Should know how to love the other person. Yes, they should know how to love. Teach your children how to hug. Your children should know that hugging is part of love. You should love by hugging. Me, I can hug for Africa. I don't know why. Some people see hugging as a taboo. They say, if you hug, don't know what the other person has, it will put onto your body. Who says? Who will put onto your body? Look, it's when you're afraid that something will happen to you, that is when that thing will actually happen. But if you have a free mind, you don't have anything, you know, worrying, you don't have anything to think about, nothing will happen to you. I can hug. If I've not seen you for a very long time, I'm just seeing you, oh my God, I hug you. If you walk into my office, I stand up to hug you. If I see you anywhere, you know, I hug. Teach your children how to hug. When we finish our morning devotion in my house, my children, everybody, they started this way and up till now they still do it. As you are greeting, you are hugging. Mommy, good morning. Daddy, good morning. Tammy, good morning. Sikki, good morning. That's how they will hug. Even if you are 20 in that room, everybody must take a hug. Teach your children how to hug. They should know that hugging is part of love. And that's why you see my children, they are not violent. They are not, you know, everything they do is calm, because they know that, you know, love is important. Teach your children how to love so that they can grow up with it. Let them be accessible. Let them be, you know, caring. Let people not be running away from them. Let people not be, even if you don't have money to give people, give them love. That is why if you come to my office, you see people, particularly the junior ones are so in love with me because, you know, I mingle with them, I love them. And that is why if I have anything during the day, I got my promotion from the first floor to the 11th floor. People were trooping into my office. I cannot count the number of crates of mineral and cartons of malt that I bought. Because of what? Love. What do I give them? Nothing. But love, care. They have a problem, they know somebody to run to. They have a problem, if you run to this person, they will get solution. Not just giving them money, but talking to them, loving them. You know, it helps to you know, stop their problem. Teach your children that loving is important. They need to love. That's why sometimes it baffles me when I see brothers, you know, brother and brothers fighting, sister and sister fighting. I don't know. My children growing up till now, you can never see them fight each other. Never. Keep malice, never. Fight, never. Quarrel, never. They don't. Please, parents, teach your children to love. It's very, very important. And then please, create an altar in your house. Create an altar in your house. Where every morning, you know, for Catholics, they have their, you know, their altar where they keep their rosary, their all the things they are using. But you know, as ordinary, you're not a Catholic, you know, the altar I mean is every morning make sure you gather your family and you pray together. I see some homes, they will come in the morning, the father will not even pray, will just go, and the mother won't pray. Sometimes, if the father prays, the father will just do on one corner, pray, so the mother will be at one corner, pray, and the children will just be, no. The family should come together. Remember, they say the family that prays together stays together, sticks together, bonds together. Yes, gather your family in the morning, even if it's 5 minutes, prepare that time for God. Teach your children how to pray. Teach them how to pray. My children, they know that whether we're around, we're not around, though, they wake up in the morning, they must gather to pray. Teach them how to pray. They should know how to pray. Let them take turns to pray. Let them take turns to read the Bible. Let them take turns to pray. You can even, apportion days to them. You have to pray on Monday, you have to pray on Tuesday, you have to pray on Wednesday. So that as the prayer, it's going on, everybody knows what time and when to pray. Teach them how to pray. Let them know how to pray. Let them know how to read the Bible. They should take turns to read the Bible. Take turns to pray. It's very, very important and very, very necessary. The Bible says, catch them young. Try and catch them young now before it is too late. And then parents, please let your children know when they are in the public. Let them know when they are in the public, when they are not at home, where they can misbehave. Yes. If you don't train them well, they will go out there and disgrace you. They will disgrace you. It baffles me sometimes when I go to the church or go to a gathering and I see children misbehaving and the mother tries to control them. No way. No way. There was a day I went to church on a Wednesday midweek service, and there was this family in front of me, just the pew, the chair in front of me. I was behind them. It was the mother, the sister, and the two children, two boys, just 2 years, 1 year, and they were uncontrollable. In fact, the mother and sister got so angry that, she was looking at the bigger one, the one of 2-3 years, to kind of for where that one, the way she was even looking at him, she was looking at that his aunt to know what the aunt would do. The woman felt so bad. The mother was with a cane to flog them. The big one broke the cane, collected the cane from the mother and broke it. The woman was so ashamed. She couldn't control them. And right where I was sitting, I was boiling. How dare these children disturb like this? Wonder why they were praying. The woman did not even listen to that prayer. She didn't even know what they talked about. It was just, her children were disturbing her. Everything that happened that day, she was not part of it. It is because she did not train them at home. My children, while growing up, never misbehaved in the public. In fact, people would only commend my children. Said, oh, wow, see how the children just take calm. Now, wow, they didn't maintain them. It's not as if, I beat them so much. No, but it's their upbringing. My children don't like public disgrace. And so when they're in the public, they maintain. Teach your children how to behave in the public. Well, in fact, if you even train them at home very well, they will not need to go to the public to misbehave. Please, parents, train your children so that tomorrow you don't start crying. So that tomorrow you won't start whooping. If you don't do it now while they are small, when they are big, I tell you, you have lost it. When they are big and out of control, it will be very difficult. You start to train them right when they are small, so that as they grow, it becomes part of them. But if you leave them and say, they are still growing, they are children, wait till they grow, and then you will see what will happen. Please. To your children. I'm not saying beat. There's a way you talk to a child. The child will even prefer talking than beating. Like my children, this is my mouth. I will talk. Sometimes they prefer I beat them than for me to talk. Because I can talk, sit them down and talk for 2 hours. Non-stop. I will talk. By the time I finish talking, they don't mellow. But when you beat, make them, they become hardened. And you not be, they stand there and say, after all, is it not beating? After all, mommy will just beat me. It's not beating. There are signs a child will see you, body language, they know what you mean. Like my daughter sits anyhow, you know, and maybe she sits opposite me or far from where I am. Once she looks at me and I do like this, she knows what I mean. Once she looks at me, her eyes sees ball to ball, and I do like this, she knows that like this means she should close her leg. And immediately she will adjust. That is sign language, body language. She knows all. Please, and mothers, please pay attention to your girls. Pay attention to your girls. I have said it before and I'm saying it again. Everything that has to do with them, please take it into action. Don't just keep quiet. Don't just keep quiet. If you are inviting uncles to your house, you're inviting uncles to your house, or you go on holidays, you know, and you know there are so many uncles in the house, please let your eyes be on your baby girl or girls. All this rape you're hearing here and there, it is done by uncles, the so-called uncles. Yes. I travel home we travel home every December for Christmas, my husband's place. And the moment we arrive, my children's cousins, my husband's sisters, their children, you know, boys, girls, they all fill my house. And for as long as we're staying there, they're going to be there with us. We're spending 2 weeks there, they'll be there 2 weeks. We're spending 3 weeks, they'll be there 3 weeks with us. And so what I do in the night, my daughter does not sleep in a separate room or sleep with them. In the night, once I'm about to sleep, my daughter comes into my room. There are other rooms, so my daughter comes into my room. She sleeps with me. For that 3 weeks, they'll be around. My daughter sleeps with me. I don't leave her to sleep. They are small, small children, you know, our age mates. But I don't give chance for anything. During the day, I'm going to the market. She goes with me. Wherever I'm going to, she goes with me. I don't leave her at home with them. I know nothing will happen, but I mean, you just have to, you know, take precaution. You have big uncle in your house, big brother, sister in your house. Please, let your eyes be on your baby girl. Don't say, it's my brother. Nothing is my, yes, nothing will happen, but you never can tell. Be watchful. Every move they make, watch. You have to be very observant. If not, you'll be taken by surprise. Because all these people that do this thing, they watch the mothers. And once they notice the mother is this kind of this person that has this attitude, nothing will happen. They penetrate. So please, be watchful. Watch your baby girls. And parents, please, when you're going to church, go with your children. Let them know the word of God. Let them know God. Start to groom them from small. Before you know it, what will be coming out of them, you'll be surprised. Please, parents, be very, very careful when it comes to our children. Be very, very careful when it comes to our children. Don't joke with them. There are mothers, when their child will misbehave, when their children will misbehave, you will say, I'll beat you. They will never not even to spank. And then, whatever we do, they are watching us. When you continue to do, the child knows that mommy, she will say, I'll beat you, and she will never beat me. And they will continue to do that until it becomes part of them. And then before you correct it, it will be too late. So please, let's be watchful when it comes to our children. Let's be mindful of things we do. Because they are watching us. And most times they tend to do what we are doing. So let them copy the good ones. The hard ones, if you cannot change it, don't do it in their presence. If you cannot change it, don't do it in their presence. Because everything you do, they are copying. They are seeing. Don't be in the house. You have a visitor. You will tell your child, hey, tell that visitor I'm sleeping. When you know you're not sleeping. You are lying. And then tomorrow you expect that child not to tell lies. Please, be mindful of what you do when they are around, because they are watching. Don't tell a child you are sleeping when you are not sleeping. They know. They may not challenge you, but they know. So please, let's be mindful. Let's be mindful. And I know that God will practice yours. It's not easy, but with the help of God, everything shall be perfect. Don't forget, we're also praying for our pregnant women and for all those believing God for the fruit of the womb. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, King of glory, that I bless you and glorify your name, because there is none like you. Be thou exalted, be thou magnified. That day, O Lord, I commit all the pregnant women before you. Father, I pray that on the day of their delivery, O Lord, they will deliver like the Hebrew women, in the name of Jesus. And Lord, as men that are looking up to you for the fruit of the womb, but Father, grant their heart desires. No woman is barren, that they will have their own children, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Abba Father, for in Jesus' mighty name.